Anytime data is being kind of transferred, we always like to talk about the security elements and aspects of things. So what are the core aspects when it comes to MQTT on the security side that people need to know about, think about, be considering, kind of that kind of stuff?
You should be using encrypted connections wherever you can. That's the first thing. I mean, that's designed for pretty much everything these days. So you would hope that it would go without saying, but certainly worth repeating. Authentication on MQTT can be done by a username and password or by more custom authentication mechanisms. And I guess the other very important thing to talk about is like your authorization. So what devices have got access to which topics? So you can segregate devices based on what they're allowed to, topics they're allowed to talk to and receive data from, so that you clearly got a distinction between devices that are reporting data, for example, and ones that are receiving. I mean, those, you know, in the examples that I've given where we've got these sensors sending data back to our backend, each of those sensors really should be only able to publish, I would guess, to a single topic. And there's no reason for them to receive any data, so they shouldn't be allowed to subscribe. So you really got strict control of where that data is going. Something that's quite nice on a security point of view, which is maybe used more commonly in MQTT than it might be in other places, is to build on that encrypted connection and actually make use of client certificates. So this is where the authentication. So normally when you do a TLS connection, getting a little bit technical, you are verifying that the server certificate matches one that you trust, and then your client will go and connect. And it's the same when you're connecting to a secure website. But what we can also do is do the same thing the opposite way around. Broker will only allow the client to connect if the client has a valid certificate. And so that's more secure than using username and passwords. And it's one of those things that I'm glad to see that there are more people starting to be interested in doing that way of thing, because it's, you know, really does have that benefit.